vivarium projects to model animals. Students create their model of an animal mind and then test their model in a simulated world. I'm Michael Travers of the MIT Media Lab. I've built a system that lets you create a brain for a logo-style turtle by wiring a neural network between its senses and its motor functions. The world consists of the turtle and some lights that it can perceive. The student starts off with a brainless turtle that is equipped with a single eye, capable of detecting lights, and motors for turning right, moving forward, and turning left. On the side of the screen is a palette consisting of neurons and some tools for manipulating them. You can drag a neuron from the palette and then connect it using this wiring tool. These are axons that will connect neurons to other neurons. What we've done here is wire the eye to the motor in such a way that when the eye is excited by light in the external world, it will excite this interneuron, which will in turn excite this forward motor neuron, causing the turtle to move toward lights. Additionally, we'll drag out this pulsar neuron. The pulsar is a neuron that is always on. It will connect it to the right motor neuron. You can imagine in a more detailed simulation that this might, instead of it being a pulsar, it would be connected to a hunger sense in the turtle's stomach. This turtle here is always hungry. Now we'll run the turtle in our world and see how it does. The turtle is moving around, the lights surround it. As you see, it's not reaching any of the lights because it never stops turning around, so it just goes in circles. We'll have to give the turtle a better brain if it's going to actually catch it. Turtle smarter is to make the turtle stop turning when it sees a light as well as going forward. We can do that with an inhibitory axon. It looks like this. We'll attach that to the right motor. Now when the turtle sees a light, as well as going forward, it will also stop the turning action. See how that does. Now it's eating the lights. And when it's done, it sits around spinning happily, looking for more. Here's a somewhat more complicated example. This turtle has two eyes and a rather more complex network of connections that enables it to home in more directly on its lights. Let's see how it does. Notice it does a good job of tracking the lights, but it gets confused when it sees more than one, or actually one in both its left and right eyes. How would you modify this design so that it would home in on either the left side but not both? That's a question for the... This is the software in graphic programming language. This provides a similar programming environment to the neural programming language seen before, but it's based more closely on a digital logic metaphor. We have gate-shaped objects which do arithmetic functions and other objects which supply or display numbers, and they're connected by wires. What we have here is a multiply by 3 engine. This box here takes the number output by the slider, which can range from 1 to 100, multiplies it by 3, and outputs the result here. As we slide the slider up, the number of the slider output changes, and it's 5, so this displays 15. You can build these devices very simply by dragging items out of the palette. One interesting item in the palette is the blimp. The blimp has 3 inputs, and these control each of the propellers on the real blimp up here. We'll wire some numbers to the blimp and see what it does. Means don't do anything. If we change it to a 1, the bottom propeller starts to spin. If we change it to a -1, it spins in the other direction. And similarly for the 2 frontward-facing propellers. Using this, you can write programs that make the blimp do specific actions. You can write different controlling networks that allow you to control the blimp in a more natural way by saying forward and back instead of turn on left propeller, turn on right propeller.
can write reflexes.
Eventually, the Bloop will be equipped with sensors, such as ultrasonic rangefinders that tell it how far away it is from a wall. Using these, we can build simple reflexes that will do things like let the blimp go around and not bump into walls or keep it a certain distance above the floor. We'll show you some simulations of that now. These are some blimp reflexes. These two sliders emulate ultrasonic rangefinders. This one, pretend this is an ultrasonic rangefinder pointed at the floor. If it gets too close to the floor and the number it output by it is too small, the blimp tries to rise. If the number is too high, the blimp brings itself down, thus maintaining itself in a particular range specified by these two input boxes here, between 30 and 40 feet off the floor. This slider represents a rangefinder attached to the nose of the blimp and stops it from bumping into walls. Usually the blimp has one propeller going forward to make it travel in a broad circle. However, if the blimp gets too close to a wall, then both propellers start going backwards to take it away from the wall as fast as possible. This is another circuit, blimp controlling circuit that provides a helm for manual navigation. Rather than controlling the propellers directly, we have several controls to provide more functional functions. This slider here controls the forward or backward direction of the blimp. This slider here controls the right and left control whether the blimp goes up, stays put in the vertical dimension, or goes down. Now we're going to send it down.
Go forward.